Hello, good morning all. Today in this video, we are going to discuss regarding how to create models in Odoo. So currently in the screen, you are seeing Odoo version 15 community edition, where we are continuing our Odoo 15 development tutorials. So in the previous video, we have discussed about how to create very basic module. And in the second video, we have shown about how to add an icon image for an Odoo module. So now we will be discussing about how to create a model in Odoo. So we all know that Odoo is using Postgres as its database. So once we come to the database manager, like when we are creating a database in the UI, it is creating a database in the Postgres. So Odoo is using Postgres as database. So most of the people will know that. So if you don't know, just keep that information with you. That is, Odoo is using Postgres as its database. And upon creating a model is called as a table in Postgres. Like we will be saying creating a new model. So what we are doing is we are just creating a table inside the Postgres database to store the data. So in this database, we already have installed the modules like sales, invoice, and inventory. So if I go to the sales, we have the sale orders here, and we have products as well as the customers. So in order to store all this data, we need a storage, or we need a database table. So for that purpose, we'll be creating a model. Once we create a model, it will create a database table, and we can define the fields and we can create the table structure. So let's see how we will be creating a model for the hospital module. So if I go to the PyCharm, here I have the custom add-ons. This is the module that we have created. So what I'll do first is I'll define a subfolder and another folder called models. So first of all, this is our module. I'll click on right click new, and I'll click on directory, and I'll enter it as, name it as models. So the model, I told we are going to create a model. So model will be creating in a Python file, and all the Python files has to be placed inside the models folder. So that is the coding structure that you have to follow while doing development in Odoo. So I have just added a folder called models. Now inside models, you have to create another Python file, init.py. Then again, you have to create a file, which is Python. You directly can create here Python file and name it as patient. Click on OK. So you can see what we have done is we have added a new directory called models, and inside that we have defined an empty init file and an empty file named patient.py. So that's what we have done so far. And what we have to do, we have to call. So this is just an information like from the outer init file. So far our outer init file is empty because we don't have any Python file to import. Now, but we have defined a models folder. So you have to import that folder from .import models. You have to import the newly added folder like this. This is the syntax from .import models. So from the outer init file, which we have created in the first video, I have just imported this folder from .import models. Then inside this, we have another init file. So from this init file, from .import patient, I'll import the patient file. So the execution will comes at here, and it will check whether we have to import something. Then we have to import models folder. Then we will get init file of this folder. Then we can see we have to import, or we have to load the patient.py file. So this is the syntax. So we have imported the patient.py file in the init. Then we will be defining our model inside the patient.py file. So before doing that, I'll take a sample. So you can see we have the Odoo source code here, Odoo. I'll go to the add-ons account, and I'll go to the models folder of the account module. You can see you have in file over here, account.account.py. I'll just copy some codes here. I'll just copy these and I will put it inside the patient.py file. So instead of typing everything from scratch, I'll just using it as a syntax. I'll explain the use of it. Okay, so what I have done is I have copied an existing sample and inside this, so we have imported the patient file, and inside this we have to import from Odoo import API fields and models. So we are importing API fields and models from Odoo to use inside our class. So now we will be seeing how to define a model. So a model will be defined as follows. So right now we are going to define a model to store the patient details in the hospital. So as we are going to create a hospital management tool, we should have a table in the database to store the patient details. So I'll be discussing about that patient model. So I'm going to create a patient model. So I'll name it as the class name as hospital patient. I'll give the class name as hospital patient. So this is the class name. So class as name models dot model. So this is the syntax of defining a class or a model. You have to do like this: class, give a appropriate name, then models dot model. So this model we have imported from Odoo. So that's done, class. Then you have to give a name for the class. So I'll give the name as hospital dot patient. So once you give the name as hospital dot patient, what Odoo do is that Odoo will be creating a database table with this given name in the name attribute. It doesn't look on class, it will be look on the name attribute of the class. So as we have given the name as hospital dot patient, in the Postgres it will create a table in the name hospital underscore patient. It will be creating a table inside the Postgres with this name. Instead of dot, it will be creating hospital underscore patient inside the Postgres. I'll show that. Then you have to define a description. Give a description for your class hospital patient. I'll copy that and I'll put it here. So once this is done, we will be successfully creating. Ignore this code, I'll keep it as commented. So once this is done, you will be successfully creating a table or model in the database. So we will be executing this code. I'll keep this code removed. So you can see I have put a hash here. Putting a hash means code will not be executing. This is means commented code, which will not be executing. If there is an hash in front of a line, the code will, you can see, it will be dimmed and that line will not be getting executed. So I'll just, instead of keeping commented, I'll remove these. So simply what I have done is I have just defined a class, given the name as hospital.patient, description is given. Now let's restart the service and upgrade the module and see what happens. So I'll just restart the service. So once you make changes inside the Python, make sure that you have restarted the service. So the service has been restarted. Now I'll go to the UI, and what we have to do, we have to upgrade our hospital module. So you can see it's not yet installed. I think I have installed or uninstalled during the last video. So I'll simply click on install. So if you have already installed, just click on upgrade. So you can see the module has been successfully installed and there is no any errors in the log. You can see there is one error. You can see a warning: the model hospital.patient have no access rule. So Odoo says you haven't defined. We will come to that later. I think that will be better. Now don't focus about that. So we have successfully upgraded the module. So if you go to the UI and if you go to the settings, just activate the debug mode, and if you go to the settings, then technical, and if you scroll down, you have a menu called database structure, and under that you can see models. So click on models. So here you will be seeing all the models or all the database tables inside used for this database DevDB. And if you search for hospital, you can see hospital patient. This is the model that we have created just now, hospital.patient. And you can see model description is coming, type base object. And fields, so we haven't defined any fields over here. We just created just a data, initiated a database, but Odoo will be bringing these fields: last update, create date, create your ID, display name, ID, write date, and write date. So these are called magic fields that Odoo will be adding to every model. We can, if we don't need, we can remove these fields from our model. Like there is one attribute that you can pass to avoid this model. So, but for the hospital.patient model, we need all this field. We need the ID, we need write date, all these things. So these are the basic field that you will be seeing in all the Odoo models. Like last update, create date, create your ID. So create date will give when the record is created. Last update will give the last modified time, created your ID. So you can just see the field label and you will be getting idea. So we have successfully created a model. Now we have to define the fields. Like we need a name field in the database to store the patient name. We need a selection field to store the gender of the patient. We need a blood group of the patient. Like that, we need different kinds of the field inside this model. So first of all, what I'll do, I'll define a name field. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to define fields inside this model or this table. So the syntax is, you have to give a name, fields dot char, because name is a character that we have to type manually. So I have to use the type char. So this is the syntax. You have to give a technical name for the field equal to fields dot. Fields is imported over here. Then you have to define its type, fields.char, fields.date, fields.text, etc. So fields.char, then inside this you have to give the string that we will be seeing in the view. So I'll give string as name, then what else, age, patient age, fields.integer. To record age, we need an integer field, age. Then what else we need? A selection field to record the gender. Fields dot will be common, and then selection, fields dot selection. I'll just copy a sample, or we can type manually, fields dot selection. Then inside this list, then I'll put male. I'll explain this, don't worry that you don't understand. Female, so I hope you understood how we define name field and age field. So regarding, while we define a selection field, you can see this is the syntax. So syntax should be like this. You should have an empty list inside, then as a tuple, like this, male, as a tuple we will be adding the values, male, the key and the value, the key and the value. So male, male, female, female, and I have given the string as gender. So I'm not going to add further fields. You can add as many as field as per your need. So we have successfully added name, age, gender, and let's restart the service and we will be upgrading the module again. So we'll be going to the UI and you can upgrade the module to see or to get the latest changes. So module has been upgraded. Now what we will be doing, we'll be going to settings, technical, again to the models menu, models, we'll be searching for hospital. We can see hospital.patient, and here you can see the name field of type character has been added, age integer, and gender selection has been added. So this is how you can define a class or a model or a table in Odoo. So this is right now, I cannot show you over here because we haven't defined any views. So that's why I'm showing here. And if you need to see your table inside the Postgres, you can go to the terminal and you can connect. So I have already connected. So let me delete this. So you can go to terminal from the PyCharm, or you can access it from the terminal of Ubuntu, or you can use the tools like pgadmin. So this is the terminal. So what I'll do, I'll switch to Postgres, sudo su Postgres. I'm just logging into the Postgres and I'll enter my password. So you can see I have successfully logged into the Postgres. Now I'll switch to the PSQL and I'll type a command /c to connect. Slash C is to connect to a database. So our database name is DevDB. DevDB. So slash C space DevDB. Click on enter. You can see you are now connected to the database DevDB as Postgres. So I have successfully logged into or connected to this DevDB. So let's select star from. I'll enter the model name, hospital patient. Put a semicolon, click on enter. You can see how ID, create your ID, create date, write your ID, write date, name, age, and gender. That is, this is the table structure that we have created so far. So I hope you understood how to create a models in Odoo. And we have different field types, so I'm not going to make this video expanded. So I'll introducing all the field types in the upcoming videos. So if you have any doubts, feedbacks, or suggestions regarding this video, please do feel free to comment it out or reach us over the email, that is odoomates@gmail.com. And if you like the videos, please do support us by liking and commenting right under the video. So that's it for the day. Have a nice day. Thank you.